Hey Bill, it's Paul.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good, how you doing?
It's been pretty crazy. I don't remember what I told you last, but it's all been like out of a dream. Like literally the whole thing with the sun and the signs, you know, like I never really even say this, but like the sun sort of is God. He is the higher power, and the heaven in our solar system is the sun. It's in the center of the sun, and this whole thing's about flying to the center of the sun. Because what happens is, like, around 3303, when I did Gematria, it was like all, that was like when the world started over. And then in May, that's like the month of God, that's when Robin and I broke up, because the power was so strong. But like after 3303, it was like there was miracles for 6 days, and on the seventh day you rest. And that was sort of in, you know, the movie. And same thing after 9/11. And it's turning out to be the same thing after Sunday. There's like days of miracles. And then I'm going back to his house on Sunday for another screening. So what I did the next day is I ended up like writing a whole other email that was even crazier. And I was telling him stuff like, you know, like it's all just Joseph Campbell times a million. Cause like I've been studying Joseph Campbell and mythology my whole life, and like Albert Einstein and everything. But the one thing that I have that they never had is a video camera and can put it on the internet in a day. And that's why this story is so weird. Like, I'm literally filming everything right when the world is wired up to watch a video overnight. It's just, it's freaky. And then I started doing was looking at the footage. And then all of a sudden, it was like, I knew what I was supposed to do. I was supposed to make a movie just about the signs, about the 3 days leading up to the solar eclipse. Because weird stuff happened with Pete. Like, I ended up having this whole conversation with him where I had an epiphany about videoing taping people discussing whether they agree or not. It's like, it's all so crazy.
Wow, that's pretty cool, though.
Well, I mean, it is pretty cool. Like, I sort of feel like this thing, I mean, I always said, right, the aliens will attack or something, and, you know, I never want to believe it's happening, but it's like I was always getting ready to give people stuff and push it on them, but I knew they were never the right people, but I was just practicing, and by equally stronger measures, I know 100% now this is the right people. Like, I mean, when you see this film, it's unbelievable. Like, my whole life, people just look at me when I talk. These people, they're literally like in heaven. I'm in heaven. We're just like in heaven together. It's so crazy.
Is there a particular place you'd like to be, Paul?
No, anywhere, just where I can sort of fit.
Be here now.
You sit on the
chair. Yeah.
Go sit on the edge of the chair.
I sit here.
Yeah. Okay.
So
this is Paul Rosenberg.
I can't tell you how many crazy things now that I signed up for all these emails and stuff I get that I always think I'm gonna do that I never do, but when I got the invitation about the trust dimension, it just spoke to me like nothing else I've ever gotten, because that's a big part of my whole concept. And but still, I was like, a million things were going wrong, and I just didn't know if I was going to go or not go. It's always like, you know, everything's a test. Like, sometimes the intention to go doesn't mean you should go, and sometimes, you know, at the last minute, you'll have clarity. But, make a long story short, I knew I was supposed to go. And then I really knew I was supposed to go, because I turned out to be the only one who went. But like,
that's what you know, right?
The whole thing didn't even exist, except for us to meet. Like, that was the purpose of last night, was for us to be here at your house today. And so my concept is the solographic principle, which is basically you go soul first, because your soul, for a lot of reasons, morally and spiritually, but it's actually a lens. And when the energy of the universe shoots through your soul, it separates everything into the 10 dimensions and positive, negative, and spiritual energy. So there's 10 dimensions and 3 energy forces in each one. But mind, we've been mind first, and that's why we've been fearful, because your mind is negative. It's not right or wrong. It's just the state of your mind, like the end of a battery. And then you go soul. But when the last two dimensions are faith and trust, and they're the hardest ones, because you sort of fail most of the time in faith and trust. Like, you know, you can sort of learn to master your body and master your mind. And faith connects you to yourself, and trust connects you to everybody else. But they may disappoint you. You may not sort of get the result you want, but the act of having faith and trust is sort of where the benefit is. And then trust is the most important one, because once you go through trust, then you have complete enlightenment, and that's Gematria, and that's dimension 11. So trust is sort of the doorway to the next
realm. The Tibetan Buddhists told us that trust was nirvana.
Yeah.
The trust frequency that we're talking about is like 1 degree below nirvana,
yeah,
which is freedom from fear, basically.
Right. So we're in complete sync.
These golden ages that occur at the beginning of these periods of the sun are amazing because we're fully connected. The rise and fall of any civilizations coincides with the activity of the sun. And it's amazing how that works, and it was put into predictable methodology with the Mayans.
And we have a solar eclipse tomorrow.
Well, that's what I was going to say.
Well, okay. Go ahead.
Well, I was just going to say, like I never, when Jamaat, everything's sort of been biblical since 2000, like literally in a bunch of ways, right? We had 9/11, like I can sort of go through each dimension and say why everything was, but it's not really the point. But the point was, what was 2012? I wasn't really sure. I kind of said to myself, well, either the aliens are gonna land, and if the aliens land, I know it's time to sort of go public with Gematria and sort of raise you, because I'm like a producer, so I'm gonna light the sky on fire, because that's all I do, is take stupid ideas and light them on fire. It could be like Gumby or whatever, but Gematria. But it just turns out, I didn't know if anything was actually gonna happen that would sort of give me the sign. And without a doubt, this week and the solar eclipse is the biggest and the closest thing I've gotten to like the green light ever.
One thing I want to say though, don't call me an alien.
Welcome and congratulations for attending your first ever Algorithmic Entertainment Experience, or AEE. In the future, all forms of entertainment will be like this, but since this is truly a very first one, it has the illusion of being all about me and my story. But I assure you, the exact opposite is true. It's much more about you and your story than mine. The whole concept of Gematria is that there's a specific vibration to everything meaningful in the universe. And once you tap into your subconscious and mind's eye, you can discover for yourself what the organic pure truth to everything is. Then you can finally lead your life based on your own truthful ideology instead of someone else's false beliefs. There has not been enough spiritual energy to do this experientially for hundreds or maybe even thousands of years. But we are truly entering a new time, and in this new time, a spiritual energy that has long lagged behind each and every one of the different factions of the system is rushing out of the darkness at the speed of light. This new spirituality is ready to be discovered by each of us, and by all of us, as one collective conscious again. These words are the first of many pure truths you will experience tonight.